Steve Dotto here. Today we're going to take a look at Skitch. What is Skitch? It's a screen capture tool that has annotation capabilities and is surprisingly useful. How it works is we capture images from our screen, mainly from our computer screen, but you can also use it on your mobility device like your iPad or your Android phone. Nothing for the iPhone yet, which we'll talk about in a few moments. But you capture your image, and then you can mark it up using their markup tools and use that to communicate your thoughts, ideas, questions, what have you. I think I better just show you how it works. Let's say you and I are going to the theater tonight, and you don't know exactly where to park because you've never been to this theater before. Well, I would call up Google Maps in that case. I would then open Skitch up, and if we take a look here at the console of Skitch, we see we've got a whole series of tools down the left-hand side which allow us to annotate whatever it is that we have captured. Down the right-hand side are our capture tools. I'm going to just click on Snap. That gives me crosshairs that allow me to determine the screen area that I want to capture. Anything on our computer screen at all can be captured. In this case here, a bit of a map. I take the picture, and now it's ready for me to annotate. Let me draw an arrow to exactly where we should consider parking. There's parking right here. I can go into my text tool, say park here, and then I can choose from the drop-down menu to email this to you, and I've communicated really effectively exactly where we should park. It's really quite easy. I love this tool. Of course, we can mark up far more than just maps. We can use it for all sorts of different things. Let's take a look at some of the tools that are here in Skitch to see if we can get kind of a better idea for how it works and what its potential is. They've really thought it out well. It comes from the folks at Evernote, so we shouldn't be surprised that it's got some nice creative tools. Actually, Evernote acquired it. Other people did the heavy lifting at the beginning, but Evernote knew a good thing when they saw it. If we take a look at the menu, we can see that we've got all sorts of typical preferences. But then as we go down to the bottom, we have a whole series of different ideas on ways that we can capture screens. I won't go into all of them in detail now, but suffice to say, it does more than just the crosshair snapshot that I just showed you. You can capture whole screens, you can have delayed captures, you can capture from your camera, you can lots of different ways of capturing images. And then you can rotate the images or modify them once you've got them. Of course, as I showed you, you also have the ability to mark them up, selecting different colors as you fill in different areas. Some people use it for just drawing up and dressing up pictures as well, I imagine. Not as sophisticated tools as you're going to find in Photoshop, but come on, it's all about quick and easy communication. Now here's where it starts to really impress me when I look at some of the additional little tools. For example, one of the things that you're always going to want to do is you want to grab, make an attachment for something that you can email or you can store. It can't be easier to save it than just see where it says drag me right here. I'm going to click on that. I'm going to drag it down and look at that. It becomes a document, a JPEG, right on my desktop, ready for me to send somewhere. And the Skitch minimizes itself, opens back up as soon as I tap on it. The other thing that I really like, and this is really useful for doing web graphics, is down here they have this resize button. If I click here, it gives me the physical dimensions of the image that I've just created. But look here, I can apply preset sizes to things, which is especially useful when we're doing web development or we're doing any work on the web. So for banner ads or leaderboards, it comes up with the standard sizes. Now this map that I just took really isn't appropriate for most of these, but you can see that it automatically formats the Skitch screen or the Skitch document into those sizes. So if you're creating little pieces for your website here or there, this tool becomes very quickly indispensable just because of this resizing feature that's built into it. Of course, Skitch also works on our mobility device, in my case, on my iPad. Curiously, it's not available for the iPhone yet, which I find a little bit surprising. I would think that because it's iOS, they should be able to get it working on both of them fairly quickly. Now, where it comes in really useful is taking pictures with a camera of your mobility device and then quickly emailing them to people for communication purposes. It does work on your Android devices, but for example, if you have a wall that's damaged and you want to get a quote of somebody to repair that, you can take a picture, draw a few directions on it, say, this is the problem here, I want you to fix this, get a new baseboard for me, that sort of stuff, and that will give you the ability then to email that and do it all from your mobility device. Of course, it's also really good for drawing mustaches on friends. That's one of my favorite uses of it. Skitch is free. It's available online. I think it's a terrific productivity tool. If this video has been useful, drop by our website. We've got lots more. We're at dottotech.com. I'm Steve Dotto. Thanks for spending this time with me today.